And then we'll go to the floor.
I want to react to Mr. Ibrahim's point. I think the point about perception is a real point. I spend my day talking to investors, convincing them to come and invest in Rwanda, and the issue of perception keeps coming up. But I think we need to make sure that we don't rely on foreign media to tell our story. And everybody has an interest. CNN has an interest, BBC has an interest, everybody has an interest. And their interest is not going to come after our interest. So I think the first thing we need to realize as Africans and as we want to change the story and to make sure that the perception is reality, is by finding ways that we can tell our own stories without relying on foreign media to tell our story. And one way to do that is to engage and transact directly with investors. What we've seen in Rwanda, for example, is when we wanted to raise money from our, you know, when we issued the Eurobond last year, we that was an opportunity to tell our story and to engage and to transact. And we went to roadshows and told investors, look, these are the laws that we put in place. If you have a commercial dispute in Rwanda, it will take it 100 days to register, to apply, and to get a judgment. If you want to register business, it's 6 hours. Our macroeconomic reforms have ensured that today we grow at an average of 8%. We have a single-digit inflation. And that is the story, and that is the engagement that investors bought in. And the result of that is that our bond was oversubscribed by 8.5%. I mean, by 8.5 times. Now, that is an investor reacting to a story that you've told them. Not CNN's story, not BBC's story, not whatever story there is, not the history of Rwanda. So I think in addressing that issue, the key thing is do not rely on other people telling your own story. Tell your own story, engage, transact, and show what is actually on the ground, and that will be really successful.
Yes, but allow me to disagree with my sister.
All right, this is the last time I'm going to allow. I want the people on the floor to start.
No, I disagree.
You disagree?
Have a discussion.
I don't disagree with him.
It is very important for us to reach. Unfortunately, Rwanda radio is not watched by 100 million people in Europe or 100 million people in the U.S. CNN and BBC and France 24 are. And this media is also ours. This concept of it is foreign media was there. No, we can go and own this media because this is a platform. And by its own code, by its own charters, it is open. Mm-hmm. And I can go and challenge the editor of the BBC, trustees of the BBC, to say, you are telling a lie. And he has to respond. So we don't turn our back. We say, oh, just because it's a foreign media, I don't use it. I'm going to rely on my own, telling my own story. Unfortunately, your voice is very, very weak. Cannot go out there. Mm-hmm. I need to go and use the media, Chinese television, the Japanese television. We news and we force our story through that media because that's how we're going to want to reach them. Otherwise, we'll stay really cocooned in our own thing. So don't be afraid of foreign media. It's just...
I need to go. I will come back to you, but I really don't want this to be a discussion on the podium. I want us to interact with people from the floor.